The Portuguese-Bend landslide started in 1956. The Los Angeles County and the city of Rancho Palos Verdes tried various ways to stop it. Caissons were installed at the shoreline. They tumbled into the ocean, just like matchsticks. A breakwater installation was studied by the Army Corps of Engineers, who decided it would not slow the movement and would require a prohibitive annual cost. The Army Corps abandoned the project. Gabions, which are nets filled with boulders, were placed along the shoreline to tame the wave action. They soon broke apart and ended up in the ocean. About 90 dewatering wells have been installed to remove water, the primary cause of the slide. Many were dry holes. Those that did function failed in a short time due to the slide motion. As of now, only 3 wells are producing water, and the area around them now looks like Swiss cheese. Without also capturing the water entering from above, it is like trying to empty a bathtub while leaving the faucet on. This land has been moving for over 44 years. Note the homes that are slowly drifting into the ocean. What you're looking at right now is the effect of 14 million cubic yards of erosion. What I'm standing on right now used to be at the top of the hills behind me where you see the scarp. That's the difference in what's happened over the past 40 years. Over 14 million cubic yards of soil have been eroded to date. Imagine dirt trucks moving every 6 minutes, 8 hours a day, 5 days a week. It would take 67 years to move that amount of dirt. The city has spent $45 million to maintain PV Drive South. It is the only arterial between the east and west side of the city. In 1970, there was only one dip. Today, there are 3, and it looks like a ski slope, with the road lowering to the point that it can go into the ocean. It needs constant maintenance. The area is served by 2 force main sewer lines.
This is a representative of just one of them. Each sewer line is running at 86% capacity. If one should break, the other one could not possibly handle 176% capacity. If it fails, it will affect over 15,000 homes, schools, and businesses, which will not be able to use any water. Additionally, once it breaks, that sewage will find its way down to the ocean.
It's time to control this landslide before we have a major ecological disaster that will be with us for generations.